hello everybody. So I am doing the video lecture for the subject computer communication networks 17EC64. So I am Aruna R, assistant professor from Sri Sairam College of Engineering. So here we'll be doing the video lecture for the module 1. So in the computer communication networks module 1, we are having the module 1 actually is having the syllabus of introduction, network models and data link layer. So introduction is the basic information, that is what is required for the computer networks to be discussed and how it is working actually. So basics of your introduction is having data communications, components used in the communication, representation, different representation, what is data flow, networks, physical structures, network types, LAN, WAN, switching, internet. Then in the next part we are having network models, that is what are the different types of network models, protocol layering, what are the scenarios, principles, logical connections, TCP/IP protocol suite, layered architecture, layers in TCP/IP suite, description of layers, encapsulation and decapsulation, addressing, multiplexing and demultiplexing, the OSI model versus what is the difference between the OSI model as well as the TCP/IP, everything will be discussing shortly. In the last part of module 1, we are having the data link layer. So that is the they have started the explanation from the second layer, that is the data link layer in the OSI layer. So in the data link layer, we are going to study the main introduction of data link layer. What are nodes and links, services, categories of links, sublayers, link layer addressing, types of address, ERP, data link control, services, framing, flow and error control, data link layer protocols, simple protocols, stop and wait protocol and piggybacking. So this is the syllabus what we are discussing about in module 1. So before we start with the computer communication network, some basic information needed to be known. So these are all the topics that are being discussed in the module 1. So let us start with the module 1, that is the first part of the module 1, that is the introduction. So in the introduction, we are going to see about the data communications, what is the networks and what is the internet. So data communications, as you see data. So what is this data is the information presented in whatever form is agreed upon the parties creating the using the data. So any information that is being agreed by the both users, that is sender as well as the receiver. For example, I am going to tell something in a sign language. So here my data is in the form of sign. So if the other person also knows the sign language, then he can understand the information. But if he is not knowing sign language, he is not able to understand. So here data can be anything, any information that is passed and agreed upon the parties. Data communication is nothing but data is some information. Data communication is exchange of data between two devices or two people or any two, sender as well as the receiver. We are some form of transmission medium because we require some medium or a channel to transfer our information. It can be air, it can be anything. There should be a channel between the source and the destination. Fundamental characteristics of data communication. So any data communication need to have some fundamental characteristics like delivery. So delivery is nothing but suppose we are sending information, we need that information to be reached by the same person what we are going to receive. We should go to the proper destination and in time, and we should know that has been delivered there successfully. Accuracy, that is it should not be added with any other information, it should be same as we have sent. Timeliness, and it should go in time. Today if I am sending and tomorrow if you are receiving, if it is very urgent and it is delayed, then we are not going to use that need. Jitter. Jitter is nothing but variation in packet arrival time. That is, instead of now when we are listening something, suddenly there is a dragging sound. That is, packets are not being received in time. So when it is delayed, that process will be not in order. So this process is known as jitter. Usually this jitter question is asked in most of the VIVAs. So keep in mind, jitter is not noise. It is the variation in the packet arrival time. So you are expecting something to arrive in time and it is getting delayed. That we call it as jitter. So telecommunication, communication at a distance. Tele is far. So telecommunication is used to communicate in the distance. So who is far away, we are using the telecommunication to reach those people. So here in this introduction, we are only seeing the general things what you people already have studied in your previous semesters. So here you are having five important components of data communication. So main five important components are, first thing, you need to have a sender, you need to have a receiver, you need to have a medium. Sender, receiver, medium are three. Medium is nothing but the channel that is connecting the source and the destination. So then you need to have a message. Message is the fourth thing. That is, you need to have some information to transfer. When we have the sender, message, medium, receiver, everything, you need to follow some rules, protocols, that is procedure. How this information, what way it has to reach to the destination, what are the steps to be carried out. So this is the protocol. So these are the five components that are very important in the data communication. That is message, information, data to be communicated. You are having a sender, you are having a receiver, transmission medium, physical path by which a message travels. A protocol is a set of rules that govern the data communication. So these five are the very important components of your data communication. Then we are having the data flow, how the data will be flowing from the sender to the receiver. So there are three major ways. Either it can be simplex, it can be half duplex or full duplex. Simplex means it is unidirectional flow of information. For example, we can take, it is a one-way communication, like a computer sending the information to a printer to print. So every time the information should go from a computer to the printer. You cannot get the information from printer to the computer. Likewise, keyboard to the mouse, or any one way of information, we can take it as a simplex. Half duplex is either of you can communicate in the given time slot. When sender is sending, receiver should keep quiet. When receiver is sending, sender should keep quiet. So half duplex is both transmit and receive possible, but not at the same time. Like one lane road with two directional traffic, walkie talkie, CB radio. Likewise, these are some of the examples. Full duplex is transmit and receive simultaneously. Both you can do at a time. Like a two-way street telephone network, channel capacity must be divided between the two directions. So you can see the two-way street where both going and coming can be done at the same time, but it should be divided properly. So this is the diagrammatic representation of simplex, half duplex and full duplex. Simplex is one-way communication, half duplex is two-way but in different slots of time. Full duplex is both directions in the same time slot. So network, when you see, a network is a set of nodes connected by communication links. So set of nodes connected together will form a network. A node is a computer. A node can be a computer, printer or any device capable of sending and receiving the information. Because we are discussing about the computer communication networks. So here our knowledge or our discussion will be limited to computers. So node can be any computer, it can be any printer or any device in the system which is capable of sending or receiving the information. Both are, either it can be sending or it can be receiving. Any one of the functions should be there. That is considered as a node. To be considered effective and efficient, a network must meet number of criteria. So what are the criteria? Is nothing but its performance, reliability and security. So any network you take, it should have a good performance. That is, whatever the information you are sending, if I am sending 100 packets, all 100 should be received at the destination. Reliability, it should be not getting added with any other information. Security is, it should be safe when it is reaching the destination. Nobody else should copy the information. So type of connection, if you see, you can have point to point connection, that is dedicated link between the entire capacity of the channel is reserved. Microwave link, TV remote control. Multi-point, either your communication can be one-to-one or one-to-many. So multi-point is more than two devices sharing a link. Capacity of the channel is either continuously shared, devices can use the link simultaneously depending on your need. Either it is using simultaneously or it is using timely, that is depending on the type of connection you are having. Timeshare users take turns. So this is the diagrammatic representation. You can see point to point is one station to one station. There is a dedicated link between them. Multipoint, if you see, you are having a mainframe that is connected to three different stations. Same link is running to all the stations. So if the information is being sent, it is depending on the time and the way the link is being shared between the three stations, that is multipoint communication. So physical topology, topology is type how it is connected. So don't get confused, physical structure is different from physical topology. Topology is the style that is used for connecting. In topology we are having mesh, star, bus and ring. So four different topologies we are going to study. Mesh is nothing but every node is having a dedicated point to every other node. So every other node is dedicatedly connected to each and every station. Every station is connected to all other station using a dedicated link. A mesh mesh network with n nodes has n minus 1 by 2 links. A node n minus 1 input output ports as links. Advantages, no traffic problem, because everybody is having their own links. There is no traffic problems. It is robust, security, easy fault identification and isolation. Disadvantages, difficult in installation and reconfiguration, space and cost. As you see, whenever it is not used also, because we need that much space to be there, the cost will become more, space will become more. If anything goes wrong, then if you have to move from one place to other place, then reinstallation will become a major. But otherwise, you see, it is having no traffic, it is robust, security. So it is having both advantages as well as disadvantages. The next topology is star topology. So star topology is having dedicated point-to-point link only to a central controller called a hub. Hub acts as an exchange, no direct traffic between devices. Advantages, less expensive, robust. Disadvantages, dependency of the whole on one single point, the hub. If hub fails, then everything is going to fail. When compared to the mesh, in mesh every node had a connection. So here every time each station has to communicate, the information has to go to the hub, and from hub it will be reaching to the other station. So if the hub fails, then everything is going to fail. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of the star topology. Then we are having the bus topology. In bus topology, you can see a long cable that links all nodes. It is having a tap, drop line, cable end. So both the ends it is having a cable end, and you are having a tap to connect the station with a drop line. Limit on the number of devices, distance between the nodes. So it should not be very near or it should not be very far. So advantages, easy installation and cheap, less cost, because only one link is running and this link is connected to every other station. Disadvantages, difficult reconfiguration, no fault isolation. A fault or a break in the bus stops all transmission. Suddenly if there is a break in the bus, then all the transmission will be stopped. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of the bus topology. Then we are having the last one as the ring topology. In the ring topology, you are having a dedicated point-to-point link with two nodes on each side. So every two nodes are connected with the link. One direction repeater. So it is having a repeater in one direction. So information, because everywhere it has to move, it will be getting. A repeater is nothing but it is like adding like a amplifier. It will be amplifying and regenerating the information. So here advantages, easy configuration, fault isolation. Disadvantages, unidirectional traffic. It is not bidirectional. A break in the ring cable disable to entire the network. If one cable breaks, then the entire network is going to break. And here you can see it is unidirectional. The information is moving in one direction. This is the advantage and disadvantage of the ring. So we have seen the four different topologies. If you remember, you have seen the mesh topology, we have seen the star topology, we have seen the bus topology, and we have seen the ring. Every topology is having its own advantages as well as disadvantages. So some of the time we need to go for a hybrid topology. So hybrid topology is using more than one topology, mixing of more than one topology together to make a beneficial method. So in this hybrid topology, you can see it is the mixture of bus and star together. So it has taken the advantages of bus topology as well as the star topology. So here in this hybrid topology example, we can see a main star topology with each branch connecting several stations in a bus topology. To share the advantages from various topology, we are going to use the hybrid topology. So this is about the different topologies used in the network. So about the categories of network, let us see in the next video lecture. I hope up to here the network topologies have been clearly understood by you people. Thank you.